We're starting with Hilchot Vesatot. Hilchot Vesatot, as we'll see, is a time of the month that a woman should perceive a period. And at that time, she has certain halachot that she has to keep and her husband has to keep. And we'll see. But first of all, as a kedama, we'll see what the Sefer, Darkei Torah, says as introduction. It says like this. It says in the Pasuk, Chachamim learn from the din of being poresh, samuch laveset, close to the time that she should receive her cycle. It says in the Pasuk, V'yizartem et b'nei Yisrael mitumatam. You should warn Am Yisrael from their tumah. What does that mean? Amar Rav Yirmiyah, it's a Gemara in Nida Samech Gimel Amud Bet. Mikan azara levnei Yisrael, sheyifreshu minoshetehem samuch laveset. This is a warning to Am Yisrael that they should stay away from their wife when it comes close to the period. V'kama, how long should they stay away from their wife not to be together? Amar Rava Ona, what's a Ona? Ona is a period of either day or night. So if she saw in the day, he'll stay away from her at the day. If she saw in the night, he'll stay away from her at night. ולכן, אם אישה צריכה להתחיל לראות ביום מסוים באחד משעותיו בוקר, צהריים או לפנות ערב. So therefore, why does it say סמוך לווסת? You should stay away close to the time that she should receive her period. Why doesn't it say on the time? Because whenever the time is, for sure you have to stay away. Rather, it means even close to it, which is the whole onah. So let's say she should see in the afternoon or the day. All day, not including the night, the night of the Ona, the Veset, the night before, wait a minute, same thing. And the day after. ואם לא תראה באותו יום, ותבדוק ותמצא עצמה נקייה, which means one of the הלכות we hinted over here, is that she has to make a בדיקה at the יום הווסת. A check, internal check. תהיה מותרת גם בלילה של אחריו, כגון אישה שצריכה לראות באחד משעותיו של יום א' בשבוע. Let's say on the Sunday she's supposed to receive her period a certain time during the day. מותרת היא בליל מוצאי שבת, she's allowed at the night, Motzei Shabbat, the night before that Sunday, ad hazricha, until the sun comes out. Now, normally, at halachot of the Torah, we always considered, you know, there's two times when the night when the day starts. The day starts at alot ha-shachar, and then, what's alot ha-shachar? When you start seeing some spark of light. And when do we consider the day completely starting? That when the sun actually comes out, which is called Netzachama. According to halacha, almost in every halacha in the Torah, the time that's called Alot HaShachar is considered already a day. Rashi in Megillah explains to us that that's a day for everything. Unlike the night that we have the time called Ben HaShemashot, the twilight, that over there it's Safek Yom, Safek Laila, it's a doubt whether it's night or day. So everything over there will be Machmir. Maybe that it's like already, for instance, Shabbat, would be machmir to call it a night already, and so on and so forth. There's different halachot that we would apply the dinim of Sfekot. But when we're dealing in the day for sure starts at Alot HaShachar. Just Chachamim said that one should start doing the mitzvot of Alot HaShachar, like for instance, Megillah, Tkiat Shofar, and so on and so forth, Brit Milah. They should start doing it in the nets in order not to be mistaken if you start Alot HaShachar, maybe you'll do it a little bit beforehand and the mitzvah was not complete. So therefore, to give it a little bit more time, the one should definitely do it during the day at the right time, they gave the Netz HaChama. This is how Rashi explains it in Megillah. So that is true in almost all the halachot in the Torah, but over here it doesn't. Although it's a machloket over here, Chavot Dat and Sidrei Tahara, but this is the halacha we posek like the Chavot Dat, that the day at for the purpose of Veset, starts at the Zricha. When is the Zricha? Netzach Hama, when the sun actually comes out, because the woman's body reacts, says the Chavadat, to the sun. Whenever the sun is out, she reacts to the sun. Same thing at night. when the sun disappears. So then we know for sure, we don't need to count, maybe it's ben hashmashot, it's the time that it's safek yom, safek laila, because in Vesatot, we don't care about that. Rather, we care about how the woman's body reacts to the sun. She reacts to the sun at that time that it disappears. And that is already good for me to consider whether the veset is over or the veset of the night is starting. V'asura b'meshach kol yom rishon, af im yesh lo sha'a kvua l'riyata, v'im lo ra'ata b'yom rishon, muteret im b'sof yom rishon, me'ashkia. Me'ashkia, as I explained right now, from the time that the sun disappeared, it's called Shkiat HaChama. Hu adin b'isha she'tzricha lirot b'layla mesuyam. If a woman needs to see a certain night, same thing. The day before, the day after, she's permitted. Only at that night, she's asur. Yeshnam deot ha'machmirot lifrosh gam ona kodem ha'ona asura. Now, there's a halacha that the Or Zarua, certain ona that the Or Zarua brings down. It's called onat Or Zarua, which means that not only at the time she should be seeing is restricted, but also the ona beforehand. So therefore, let's say she should receive at the day. That's what she saw last month. So that day is definitely asur. The halacha does not permit that at all. But some poskim, like the Bach, the Shach, bring down this onat Or Zarua, meaning that also the ona beforehand should be restricted. Not only during that day that she saw, but also the night. So she'll be asur for about 24 hours, right? And the question is, did Sfaradim receive such a chumrah? By Ashkenazim, it's much more common. By Sfaradim, did they receive such a chumrah? So the Sefer, Darkei Tahara, brings down like this. He says that it's not asur. Kamur mikar adin maspik lifrosh rak baota ona. וראוי להחמיר לפרוש עונה אחת קודם העונה אסורה, בגלל שבימינו נחלשו הגופות וסדירות הדבסת נתונה לשינויים על ידי גורמים חיצוניים, יש חשש סביר שאישה תקדים לראות עונה אחת. Says the Darkei Tahara that it's correct to be מחמיר the עונה beforehand. The Ben Ish Chai brings like that. The truth of the matter is that Sfaradim did not accept at all this Chumrah. Chacham Ovadia brings down that there's no room for this Chumrah whatsoever. Also the Or Letzion held that there's no room for this chumrah whatsoever, and the poskim Sfaradim at large don't have that chumrah. In Eretz Yisrael, they say that some bnei Torah want to be machmir like that chumrah, they direct them to be machmir such a chumrah. But meikar adim Sfaradim did not receive such a chumrah whatsoever. Now he continues and says that בפרישה זו של העונה אסורה יש מחלוקת אם היא אסורה מדאורייתא או מדרבנן. This that we have to stay away from our wife at that time, is it Isur Deoraita or the Rabbanan? Because we learned from the Pasuk that I mentioned before, V'izartem et b'nei Israel mitumatam. You should stay away. You should warn Am Israel to stay away at the time of the Tumah. So we see that it's Deoraita. Some learn, indeed, that it is Deoraita. It's a machloket. Rav Shmuel, it's a machloket Rishonim. But lemaaseh, יש הסוברים שכל העונה היא רק מדרבנן, ורק שעת הווסת עצמה וסמוך להם מדאורייתא. As I explained to you before, that the time that she should be seeing exactly that hour, that could be that it's דאורייתא. Many poskim hold like that, and everything around it, all the other timing during that day, that's called סמוך לעונה. So that is something that would be דרבנן, סמוך לווסת. And להלכה, הלכה למעשה, we posek that it's only the Rabbanan. This is how the Shulchan Aruch was posek in Kuf Pei, Dalet, Seif, Gimel. Now, when we're dealing with Vesatot, we're dealing with two different types of Vesatot. It's important to remember that. And one type is called Veset Kavua, another type is called Veset She'eno Kavua. Veset Kavua means that a woman sees consistently every single month on the same exact time, same day. And therefore, she builds herself a chazakah to have a veset kavua, which would, the halachot would be more strict in a way and more lenient in other ways. We'll see. And that today, it's very unusual. It used to be that according to the way the Shulchan Aruch writes, is that women have normally veset kavua, But Shevet Alevi says, and it's pretty much anybody that's Osek in those inyanim knows, that today women do not have Veset Kavua. Very, very uncommon for a woman to build herself a Veset Kavua of three times, seeing consistently with a pattern. And we'll see what it means.
It's in her control?
No, it's not. That's what since. No, it means that every month it comes on exactly the same time as last month. So she builds herself a pattern. It's a pattern that she'll have to continue and worry about next month exactly on that time. That's called Veset Kavua. Veset Sheino Kavua means it's random. One time she sees here, one time's there. There's no set timing. Once she'll see in 29 days, one in 30 days, one 27, and one time at night, one time during the day. That's all women today. All women today. It doesn't come as a pattern of seeing on a regular time. So, Veset Kavua, Sheodati Beverur Maya Ona Ba'a Shetireba, Ubirur Ze Nikva Begimel Pe'amim. To build that pattern of Veset Kavua, you'll have to have three times that she sees exactly the same, on the same Ona. Tzicha Lifrosh Bo'onat Vesta, if she did become such that she'll have Veset Kavua, she'll have to be Poresh on that Ona. Ruhi Lifrosh Gamona Kodem, he says that on Veset Kavua, you'll have to be Poresh Veset Kodem. He holds halacha lemaaseh that Veset Kavua, that is when you come up with the chumah of the tumat of the Or Zaruah. Yeah? That is when you machmir on the Or Zaruah. Tzichal v'raui lifrosh gamona kodem. Veset aguf gam hu veset kavua em nikva begimel pe'amim. We'll see. Now, what's a veset sheino kavua? Kevan shetzichal lirot bezman kolshu. Now, woman would see a certain time during the month. And therefore, but ku chachamim matzu et hayamim asvirim biyoter shetireh bahem. He says that chachamim looked at the most likely days that a woman should see in those days, which means a woman that doesn't have a pattern, like all women today. Therefore, when should we suspect that you'll see them, that you'll have to take precaution? You can't live together at those timings, because those timings are likely that you'll see them, so you have to take precaution. So they found three different dates that the likelihood to see them is higher. What are they? Ona Benonit. Ona Benonit means the 30th day to the last time she saw. She counts 30th day, including that day that she saw. That's called Ona Benonit, and that is something that the Poskim brought down as more strict than other Vesatot, other Onot. But that is the first Ona. Rashi says, why is it that she'll count 30 days? This woman doesn't see on the 30th day. She sees one time on 50, one time on 36, one time on 47. What's the 30? She doesn't even come close to it. The answer is that since most women see on 30th day, Chachamim said, this is how Rashi explains, therefore Chachamim said that we'll be worried about that today. Secondly, Yom HaChodesh, which means she'll count and she'll see on the calendar when she saw last month on a Jewish calendar, and we'll take that date, let's say it was Kafchet Tishrei, so we'll do Kafchet Cheshvan. Exactly that date on the Jewish calendar. Haflaga. Haflaga means you count the differences between the previous Reiya, the previous time she saw, and last time she saw, which means previous to this last time she saw. We go 2 months beforehand, and we see when she saw then, and we go to last month, and we see the difference between the two. How many days passed between the Reiya 2 months ago and last month? And this is the number that will count for this month as well. So let's say she saw 28 days in between. So we'll count 28 days from the previous Reiya, from last month to this month, and that's the day she'll stay away from her husband. Now he mentions the following things. Mekevan shelo baruch shetireh baotam yamim, chumatam larov ktana miyom ha-prisha shel ba'alat veset kavua. Of course, that one that sees on a pattern or three times at the same time, which is we call veset kavua, such a woman will have more strictness on that day. And for instance, he says, צריכה לפרוש רק בעונה שראתה בה, ואינה צריכה להחמיר ולפרוש עונה קודם. He says that you be מחמיר only on the or if you want to be מחמיר like the Orzawa, like he brings that ראוי להחמיר, it's correct to be מחמיר. So he says it's only when you have וסת קבוע, but not when it's not וסת קבוע. חוץ מעונה, yeah? That's a very important point that he says here. חוץ מעונה בינונית שראוי לחשוש בה גם לעונה הקודמת, כי חוששים לעונה בינונית כלווסת קבוע. Meaning this. We're saying that עונה בינונית, חכמים looked at it as part of וסת קבוע. They gave it the same strictness as וסת קבוע. They saw that such a וסת is more strict than other וסתות. So he says, the darkei tahara that you have to be machmir on veset of onah benonit, also taking the veset of the or zaruah, onat or zaruah. You hear what I'm saying? Now, many poskim disagree with what he said right now, and they say, on the contrary, since you have such a veset sheno kavua, so therefore, on onah benonit, definitely you don't have to be machmir. This is how the Divrei Yatziv Siman 9 Bet says, that you don't have to be machmir on onah benonit. Why? Because the whole idea of onah benonit is v'chilo tireh le'olam. You think this woman is never going to see, so we give it a certain day that we're saying the likelihood is for the most women. But therefore, it's not based so strongly that she'll see on that day. So you can't be pushing her now to have extra strictness to keep onat or zaruah. So therefore, what he says here is also something that is a machloket. Since it's a machloket for Sfaradim that didn't accept onat benonit, and it's a chumra altogether, and on such a machloket, therefore, I don't think that one should take the extra chumra that he brings. First of all, it's a chumra. Secondly, to say that it belongs to Ona Benonit. Now, it continues and says, אישה שרואה לפעמים ביום ולפעמים בלילה, אף שאינה צריכה לחוש אל הראיתה האחרונה, ראוי להחמיר ולחשוש גם לעונה בינונית. There's such a thing called that days that are, maybe she'll see them, maybe not, because previously she's been seeing them in them, yes or no. Sometimes she saw, so we go a few months beforehand, we see the certain days that she sees, although she didn't see it now. It's called Yemei HaMevucha. We'll get to that and we'll understand what it means more. What do you do on the time that you have such a Yom HaVeset? What's permitted to do, what's not permitted to do, what's required to do, and what's not? Like, for instance, can you take a bath at that day? The poskim say not to take a bath. That's how the prisha brings down. Ben Ish Chai is posek like this. Many poskim bring down halacha lemaaseh, Chamo Vadia, not to take a bath at the day of the veset. Why not? Because you're avoiding the evidence. You're destroying evidence right now. It should be that maybe she has today dam starting, blood starting, and when she takes a bath, she's destroying that evidence. She washes it out. Now, let me explain to you that when we're talking about taking a bath, we're only talking about bath, not a shower. Shower is permitted. This is how the Sha'ar HaTohar brings down that the chumrah of the prisha is only a bath. Bath means you go inside the water, whether you go to the ocean, you go to the pool, you go inside the water, so you're washing out the evidence. But taking a shower, that's permitted. That's external. It doesn't do anything for the internal, and therefore such a thing would be permitted. But we'll get to that in a minute. Let's just see what a woman is required to do at Yom HaVeset. One of the things she has to do, besides staying away from her husband, we'll see what kind of halchakot they have to do on that day. It's not like regular nida, very, very different. But a woman is required to do on that day bdika, a check. בימים אלה שהאישה חוששת ופורשת בהם צריכה לבדוק אם היא רואה או לא. That's the halacha brought down in Shulchan Aruch Kupe Daled, סעיף ט. כאשר יש לאישה וסת קבוע ובו יש לה שעה קבועה שבה היא רואה, צריכה לבדוק רק באותה שעה. If there's such a woman that has וסת קבוע, that we said today doesn't exist, almost not. And it's not only on a certain day, but it's also on a certain hour. It used to be women's body was like a watch. Every time on the exactly the same time she would see during the month. This is how it was. Bodies have changed tremendously in the last generations. And therefore, when they had such a thing, they would see exactly the same day, exactly the same time. So she'll have to do on that time. But today, that they don't have the same time, and they don't have the same day. ואם אין לה השעה קבועה, צריכה בדיקה כדלקמן. וכן כאשר יש לאישה וסת הגוף של... There's other וסתות called וסת הגוף, when a woman sneezes, or she has other reactions in the body, that shows, like, that's the symptoms of having a period at that time. צריכה לבדוק רק בשעה שמתחילה לפעק או להתעטש. If the reaction comes at the time that she's supposed to see her period, that is when she checks. Because that is the veset, on that time. It's called veset haguf. Isha she'en la veset haguf, or veset l'sha'a, if a woman doesn't have any of those, like we said today, women don't. So therefore, she'll be checking, she can check any time during that ona. And a big machloket if she needs to make two checks or one check. But regardless, she'll make a check during that ona. If it's a day, she'll make a check during that ona, and that's it. Habdika tova biyoter. So he brings over here a big humra that the poskim don't bring. Chavot dat like this, to put a moch dachuk. Moch dachuk means you put something inside, you put the cloth inside, and you leave it there. That if there's something that comes out, you'll catch it. So he says it's a great bdika. La'alacha, we don't do it, we don't recommend to do it because it causes women discomfort, it causes women to have also all kind of scratches, and this is something that we don't do. In the end of the day, mochdachuk is done at the time of right after the Hefsek Tahara. We're talking today about veset, which means a woman is clean, she's permitted to her husband, came day of the veset. Day of the veset that she saw last month, she counted whether ona benonit, or she counted, or she saw on the calendar where is Yom HaChodesh, or she counted and she saw when is the aflaga, and now she has to make a check. What kind of check does she make? So we're saying la'alacha, she makes a regular check with the cloth, and she doesn't need to leave the cloth inside like she would do a moch dachuk for the Hefsek Tahara. Okay? Now, how do you stay away from your wife at that time called Yom HaVeset? בימים אלה שהאישה עדיין לא ראתה וצריכה לחשוש שמא תראה אסורים הם רק בתשמיש המיטה, אבל חיבוק ונישוק מותרים ויש אוסרים. The Shulchan Aruch says that on Yom HaVeset, in Kuf Pei Dalet, Sif Bet, he says that everything's permitted except being together. Being together means תשמיש המיטה, which means חיבוק ונישוק, says the Shulchan Aruch, it's permitted. One is allowed to hug his wife, to kiss his wife, and everything else. They're allowed to sleep in the same bed as well. This is how the Shulchan Aruch brings down. The Taz and the Shach, which are the main Nosei Kelim of the Shulchan Aruch, disagree with that, whether they don't permit Meikar Adin or as a Chumrah. Machloket Taz and Shach. Taz says it's Meikar Adin not to kiss your wife at that time because it could lead you to do Isu. This is how the Taz and the Shach brings down. And la'alacha, for Sfaradim, Sheshkenazim would be machmir in that. For Sfaradim, we don't find such a chumra, and therefore this Sifchei Tzedek, and this is how he's posek over here in Darkei Tahara, and this is how Chacham Ovadia is posek, that chibuk v'neshuk is permitted, unless you know it's going to lead you to somewhere it shouldn't lead you, which means either it bring you too close to her that you want to do the tashmish, or it will bring you to hirurim, that's also not a good thing to have. That's when you'll have to be machmir. How about sleeping in the same bed? The poskim, like Chacham Ovadia and he himself over here, are machmir and sleeping in the same bed on that time, because they're afraid that if you sleep on the same bed, maybe she'll become tameh, because that's the time she should be getting her period. So maybe she'll be tameh at that time, and you'll be sleeping with a nida. This is how the Ben Ishchai also brings down in Parashat Tzav Shana Shnia. But lemaaseh, if you take a look at the Shulchan Aruch permitted all kind of things. There's no hachakot whatsoever except being together. So over here,
during the day, and meaning he wakes up a few hours after the Tashach, should he not sleep with his wife the night before?
No, you don't have to. You don't have, it's already a chumah. You don't have to, like, be megavev chumrot, you know, take an extra chumah on top of a chumah, on top of the chumah. This is already a chumah, because again, according to Halacha, Shulchan Aruch permitted. He said, no problem. Came the later poskim, like I mentioned, Ben Ishchai and Chacham Ovadia, and said, don't sleep together. It's not a good thing. Not that it's, but it's not a good thing because she might become nida, but to take it to the next level already, that much.
How do they know?
Yeah.
How do they know that all these activities that they are not hearing, besides sleeping, you know, besides
right.
Tashmita,
yeah.
How do they know that these activities are not going to lead to Tashmita?
So that's what we're saying. Each person himself knows himself. And if a person feels that if he does chibuk v'nishuk, it would lead him to Tashmish HaMita, he should stay away from it. But every person
is very confused.
Every person should know for himself. Every person knows himself. Nefesh yodat. How does it say? Nefesh be'emta. Yodat nefesh be'emta. Yotze laderech. There's something called that a person goes to the road, which means you go to a trip, whether a business trip or you go to a vacation, right? When a person goes to a trip without his wife, he has an obligation to be with his wife. The Shulchan Aruch says that it's a pele Shulchan Aruch, but that's how it's posek. It's machloket Rashi and Tosfot. But lehalacha we posek, hayotze laderech tzarich lifkod et ishto afilu beyom vesta. Even though today is the Yom of Veset, the Shulchan Aruch says, not that it's a nice thing to do, tzarich lifkod et ishto, vafilu samuch levista. וביום ויסתה עדיף לרצותה בדברי אהבה וחיבה אם היא מתרצית בכך ומוכלת לו. Why? The Gemara says that a woman has a special need at the time when her husband leaves the town. So therefore, because of that, a person has to appease her with that. If a person could speak to her heart and with that she's satisfied and she's happy, fine. If not, he has to be together with her. This is the way the Shulchan Aruch is posek halacha lemaaseh, with the exception that if a person goes to a mitzvah, if a person goes to do a mitzvah right now, that's the reason he lives down. So, osek b'mitzvah, patur mina mitzvah. Chazak v'aruch.